I think that what I'm afraid of most right now is that people, after today, after the first day, you know, humans are so good at adapting. That's what's scary about us. We are so good at adapting, you know? We're like frogs in that pot. We're just like, how warm is it in here? Oh, is it getting warmer? I hadn't noticed, because we're so good at that. We're really good at that, you know? I saw a bunch of people online actually pointed out that People Magazine kind of got a jump on the... People Magazine is already starting to run their sort of puff pieces, like you expect, all about Melania and her kids and sort of like normalizing everything, sort of talking about how, you know, like creating those sort of celebrity pieces. That's what I'm afraid of. I'm afraid of that the process of normalization. You can see it in my Facebook feed and the Twitter. You can see different people as the anger spikes. It's so hard to hold on to anger. It's so hard to hold on to love. But both of them sort of burn, and so there's a tendency to pull back toward the middle, say, well, we know what he was like during the race, but maybe now, you know, now with the mantle of authority on him, you know, he has such a track record when given power to reacting to that well. Maybe this time he'll really handle it really well, unlike the last 50 or so years that we have amply documented. Perhaps this is the moment that things go differently. You can think that. You can wish that. I think you're a fool. I think you're a fool. I think anybody wishing that is a fool, and I think the institutions that reinforce that, including the journalists who've aided and abetted in the rise of this person, I think those people should be the first against the wall when the revolution comes. I swear to fucking God. And it's going to be a grim accounting, because I think some of us are going to have to think about whether we belong against that wall too. I mean, we're really going to have to think about how easy it is to find accommodation with these things, with the racism, the bigotry, the things that fed this guy's candidacy were always there. They were always in America. We made these choices. We made choices because it is hard to confront things over and over and over again. I do it too. You start putting up with things. You start accepting things as they are. You start saying, all right, that's how it is. It's always easier to do that. And it is so fucking hard to actually hold the line. And I think we're going to need to do that. I think we're going to need to really hold the line on this person, because I'm afraid of this man. I'm very afraid of this man. I've actually never had someone who had power in this country who I felt like was potentially an existential threat to the existence of this country itself and its continuity as a society that is democratic. I haven't actually ever felt that, and I'm a crazy artist type. So I felt all kinds of things. I'm prone to saying all kinds of things. You're like, that's great! And I yell about things. I've never felt this way about anyone or anything in my life as I feel about the clear and present danger of the immense power this man has just been handed with no checks upon it. And it's so hard because we feel powerless. Like, I felt like I did everything I possibly could. I did everything. I used my art. I did all these things. There's a great lesson in that. The lesson is, you know, sometimes you're the hammer, and sometimes you're the anvil, and sometimes you are that which is trapped between. You do not always win. This isn't a storytelling book, you know. These aren't fairy tales, this life we have. Just because you try so hard and you've done the right things does not mean it is going to work out. Sometimes it doesn't turn out the way that we wish it would. Sometimes it doesn't even turn out the way that is right. And you can see the other path glimmering for an instant before it vanishes. And it does vanish. And you can cling to it, or you can get up and start walking forward. You don't have to do that today. You're sitting in an audience. This is a speech for me. I'm building myself up to get into the show. And I appreciate your indulgence in putting up with it. The thing I...